I discovered something during a very simple conversation with my son. He bought me a video and it was showing how the Chinese people have invented this invisible cloak. And what this invisible cloak does, it make you disappear. You know, as crazy as that sound is, true, it make you disappear. Now, do I have one? No. Have I seen one in person? No. Would I like to? I don't know. I'm not sure. We did see it on the internet and I looked it up and found out that these things really do exist. And this is a technology that they've been working on for a while. And here it is. So again, you put this piece of plastic over you or whatever that stuff is, and it make you disappear. And so we was kind of like looking at it like, man, like that's crazy, right? So then he was like, as he was walking away, because he's got home from prison. So he obviously been doing a lot of reading, but he was a reader before he left. But anyway, that's a whole nother point. So he said, man, you know that that's the invisible cloak that's in the Harry Potter book. And I'm like, no, I don't know nothing about that. So he was going on and talking to me about it and breaking it down. So I looked it up and found out that, wow, he was right. The invisible cloak is one of the three magical artifacts that grants the owner power over death. Now, we talked to y'all about that these do-dirties and these evil forces, that their ultimate goal is to play God. And if they are the owners of the power of death, to control death, then that's just another way for them to control their population. Now, I want to give a disclaimer. I am not saying this is going to work. I am not saying that this is what's going to happen. I'm telling you what I have an idea, what they plan to do and what they planning out. But we know that God is much bigger than all of these plans. So I'm not inflicting fear. I'm not trying to tell you that, oh, we should be scared because it's completed. But at the same time, I am bringing you awareness to what I see. You make your own conclusion and come up with your own opinion, but I'm just giving you information. So like I said, that these three magical artifacts that grants the owner power over death. So whoever get it has the power over death, right? And these are three components that it take to make that happen. You got to have the Elder Wand, you got to have the Resurrection Stone, and you got to have the Invisible Cloak. Now let's start with the Elder Wand and we get to the cloak last. So the Elder Wand is this. I have to. I can't help it to see it only one way, that this is MK Ultra. This MK Ultra, because MK Ultra will give you control over one's mind. Now, this is, and for the people that don't know what MK Ultra is, and without going deep into it, you can look it up and Google it yourself, because that's not my main point here. Designed and created by the government, and it's a real thing that they have even admitted to doing. They admitted to this, and they banned it. It's supposed to be illegal, but come on now, do you think they stop doing it? I don't think so. They still got it going on, or at least they have access to it, so they have the power to do it. And I really think a lot of y'all MK Ultra, because you don't listen. It's kind of weird that you see things right in your face and you say, nope, that's not it. This is a blue car right in your face. Hey, what color is that car? That car is white. And it's like you debate and then call me crazy and say that I'm wrong and I'm evil for saying that the car was blue when I'm looking right at it. So that gives me some type of indication that MK Ultra is really, really, really jumping off in a lot of people. Hope it ain't hit me. Maybe I'm the crazy one. Maybe I'm MK Ultra, but I don't think so. Number two is the Resurrection Stone, and that's conquering death. And so let's break down what that is. Again, like they said, I compared that to the Neuralink. So we all know that Elon Musk got all these things you can put in your head and all this different stuff, and you can live forever, or you can, you know, be young forever. And or in essence, they can take the link and they can take you out or make you smarter, make you useful, unuseful, whatever it is. If you submit to it, a lot of people convert that to the mark of the beast. That's a whole different conversation, and I let Merlin talk to you about that because I'm not into that to that degree. And I just, you know, for some reason, I don't care. I just follow God, and that's it. And where it lead me, that's where it do. But I don't know much about that. Is much to be sitting here talking about it, but I do know enough about the Neuralink and what it's supposed to be doing, and it controls your brain, and it gives you all this crazy stuff. So that's the Resurrection Stone. You know, you're conquering death. You said, hey, I'm gonna live forever. And this is basically what they are promising you to be able to do as it go on. Again, playing God, because man has no reason to be doing anything like that. So let me jump through the middle real quick and kind of go back to the beginning. I think the author of this book was some J.K. Rowling, some lady named J.K. Rowling. And so now it makes you wonder, before I get to the last one, the cloak, it makes you wonder, was this book written intentionally? Because we all know that what they do is they tell us everything. You know, they gotta show us, they gotta tell us, because God ain't gonna allow them to sneak us. At least he's given us, you know, saying the rights to say, hey, this is what it is, this is what that is. You can follow whatever you want to follow, but at the end of the day, that's on you. So I'm just telling you, just really think about that, because I know it might sound crazy that, so why are you connecting all this? Well, I mean, I'm just looking, you know what I'm saying? And I see what I see, and I got to share it with you. And y'all can tell me what y'all think about it, you know what I'm saying, in the comment section. So moving on to the invisible cloak, let's break down what that is. So I just talked to y'all about the invisible cloak and where it came from and who got it. Now, if you really want to link all this, let's do it like this. Look at I hate to say this to y'all, but look at the position that Elon Musk is in, right? He's in a good position. He got good relationships with the president, Trump, that's coming up here. As soon as we, you know, switch authority over to him, they are like really, really in the game together. You know what I'm saying? Really, really close. And I'm not saying everything is connected. I'm not saying it ain't connected. I'm just saying pay attention to what you see. You know what I'm saying? And be led by the spirit. But it's a lot going on. You know what I'm saying? And all three of these things seem to be connecting. And along with all the other things that they got going on with our foods and just, man, so much technology moving and so many things coming together. It just really makes you wonder what's going on, because there's been a whole lot of what we would probably consider to be weird or crazy things going on, not just in America, but in the world. You know what I'm saying? It's just like, all I can say is just pay attention. You know what I'm saying? Be alert. You know what I'm saying? Stand on your ground and just follow God and be led by the spirit, because it's too many different things happening at one time. And everybody, this person saying that, this person saying this person saying that, disbelieve this book is God. That book is, look, man, you know what I'm saying? You gotta really, really, really pay attention to what's really going on out here and, you know, see what's being manifested right in your face. So connect those and y'all tell me what y'all think in the comment section and do that add up to anything. And if so, we can have a deeper conversation about it. And I don't claim to be an expert on it. You know what I'm saying? It's just something that kind of came across my table and I decided to share it with you. And really, I really want to know what you all think about it. So leave it in the comment section. Hit me on the email, toostrongpodcast@gmail.com. If you want to discuss it further, if you have more deeper information about it, maybe we can do a video together or even do a live. You know what I'm saying? We'll figure that out. I'm just curious. It popped up. It came. I want to know what y'all think about it. Put it in the comment section and wake up before you go to sleep. Peace. We out of here.